Okay. Single life. A single life. Alright. Good evening, everybody. We are back with Resident Evil Remake. And last time, we did a couple of things. You know, we wandered around the mansion. We pretty much cleared the mansion. I looked back at my recording at the stream yesterday to see if I missed anything. And I did miss one item. It's just it's a minor thing, but if we happen to pass by there again, I'll pick it up. I feel dumb for not having done it before. Anyways, also today I do have a couple of different settings than the ones I had last time. I mean, it's nothing too drastic. I just what did I do? What did I do? But anyways, I just changed like the encoding process for this, so the image might look a little bit not as good, but that in exchange we should hopefully not have stuttering issues like we did yesterday. So hopefully that won't be a problem. If it is a problem, well, damn. Anyways, whatever. So let's go in. First things first, drop this back in here. And hold on. Yeah, that's what I wanted. Should I keep the shotgun on me, or should I switch back to the handgun? It might be better to just switch back to the handgun, actually. So, let me do this real quick. And then just because I'm OCD like this, let me have the gun on top and then the things on the bottom. And do I need anything else? I don't... Well... Okay, again, we haven't encountered... Until I encounter any zombies, I'm not gonna bother bringing this with me. If we do encounter zombies, then I'll go ahead and take it. But if we don't need them now, then yeah, I won't bother. Okay, so first things first, let's go ahead and equip our pistol. And just keep going over here. So what's going on around this area? Let's see. I am gonna be a little bit wary of things around. Okay, so there's like... Crank. And let's see. Okay, so you. There's nothing unusual. We check it over here. The end is shaped like a square. So now we know it's a square crank that will only fit into square spaces. Which makes sense. Which would suggest that there will be other kinds of cranks around. If not, it would... Oh god, what? Oh no. Oh no. Well, that's just unfortunate. Some monster came in and fucked me over. Okay, that's not good. Ow. Alright, so you guys remember the monster that was being told about chains and stuff? Yeah, that's her. That would be Lissa. That is the person we've been seeing around here. She lives here. So this is once again, just like Fatal Frame, the golden rule of no enemies in a safe room has once again been broken by this fucking game. But again, she, if we remember Barry's advice, she is unharmed by guns, so there is no point in fighting her. So we just gotta leave. We got what we needed. We don't need to come back here. Well, not now, at least. We might need to come back here later. But, again, not at this precise moment. For now, we're just gonna keep going here. And there's nothing else around here now, is it? I don't know. Anyways, you... Oh, hi, there's a zombie here now. Where? Oh, there. Okay, I can just walk around here, can't I? Yeah, I can. It's just staring off into the distance. I don't need to bother him. Okay, whatever. Don't matter. Let's just keep going. I do have my, the wind quest, so we can put it in the one slot here in one of those gravestones. Alright, so these crows will get aggressive eventually. And by eventually I mean now. But I'm not gonna bother too much with them. Ah, okay, cool. So that one unlocked a bunch of other ones. Quests are fitted. Take the moon crest. Ow! No, hey, hold on. Star crest. And sun crest. Okay, now let's examine them real quick just in case there's anything. There's an icon depicting the moon. Aha! There's a button. Will you press it? Sure. There are two projecting lines. Okay, cool. How about this one? The star quest. There's an icon depicting a star. There's a button. Will you press it? Okay, so that one's shaped like a star. Like a cross, I think. I mean, this platoon in the shape of a cross. And then you, the sun crest. You have like a tree thing. Alright, so... three projecting lines. Okay, so... that's probably going to be important to know. Okay, so... yeah, there's the three symbols. There's something carved into the indentation. Two vertical lines, a cross, and three horizontal lines. Could it be some kind of symbol? Well, that's cool. So the moon has the, has that one. The star has the cross. And then the sun has the three lines. So what's that gonna unlock? Oh, hello! And a gun? That's a gun. A gun has been placed neatly inside. I'll take it. Will you take the Magnum Revolver? I will definitely take the Magnum Revolver. That is, if I am not mistaken, the most powerful weapon in the game. Besides a particular weapon that will get on literally the very, very end. Other than that one, this is... that will pretty much one-shot anything that isn't a boss. Or Lisa, which... Lisa is technically not a boss, she's just... there. But anyways, yeah, we'll definitely keep this around. Okay, cool. So... let's keep going over here. So, we're pretty much done with that area around down there, or at least for now. But I think we'll probably have to come back there later. But... anyway, since I now have... a chance to go back to the mansion, I think I might go ahead and try to... grab that one item that I forgot to grab. Just cause I'm gonna be going in that general direction. Well, not really, but... I'll be coming around here. Alright, so that's nice. Okay. And again, it's nothing particularly important. I just want to grab it. Okay. And again, I'm not too worried about health because I do have like a bajillion healing items. So this is like a it's person's family emblem, so we can't open this quite yet. Anyways, yeah, we do have a bajillion healing items in the item box, so I don't need to worry about that. And am I going the right way? Yeah, I am. Okay, cool. Just got a bit confused there for a second. Alright. Just random thunder. It happens occasionally. Can try to spook you. Incidentally, while I was doing the test recordings today to... hi. You're here now. Okay, I'm not gonna bother with you. I'll just leave you alone for now. And anyways, yeah, while I was doing test recordings today, I was playing Resident Evil 0 for the first time. You know, because I need something to test on my PS4, and I don't have that many things I wanted to play, so I just grabbed that since I'm in the Resident Evil mood. And I mean, it's alright. I'm definitely much more satisfied with this game. Anyways, here's the thing we forgot. It's a measly dagger. I wanted to pick that up. But anyways, yeah, I think that's everything. Alright, so... it's alright. We will stream it when the time comes to stream it. But, definitely not, not nearly as good as this game. That's the remake. And probably part of that is because, well, two things. Is because that game has, like, no item box. So if you want to put anything, any items anywhere, you got, what's the name of it? What is it I'm trying to say here? I mean, basically you have two characters and you need to, like, share inventory with both of them. So that kind of, you have to, like, really, really manage your resources and stuff. And by really managing, I mean you have to leave stuff on random places and you have to come back to them. It's kind of annoying. And another thing, because you're constantly accompanied by someone, the fear factor really, really goes away. So the game is not really that scary. Like, this game is pretty freaking scary. Resident Evil, Zero is not really that scary. At least so far. I played it for like 3.5 hours doing different test recordings during those times. And, yeah, I don't think I got spooked even once. Which was just weird. But whatever. We'll still stream it sometime. It's not a bad game. It's just could be better. Alright. I should have probably stopped by a save room and dropped this. But I don't want to go back though. I really don't. Okay, whatever. Let's just keep going. I have cleared this place, right? Yeah, okay. Let's keep going into the courtyard. Because this is the area here. Also, I do apologize for any noise happening in the background. Because I do have a fan pointing at my computer so that it doesn't overheat.
If you can hear me, just give me a sign. Anything.
Jill to Brad. Can you hear me? Shit. It's broken.
Well, it's broken. Now we know. Oh, that. Hi, that's a dog. That's another dog. There's dogs in here. Just hanging out. There's a lot of. Oh, hi, there's a new herb. That's a new kind of herb. Okay, so if I'm not loud, will the dogs leave me alone? There's a question here. Cause I don't wanna bother them too much. Oh, do they have poor vision? Like, they are not actually coming after me. Maybe they can't see very far. Or have poor hearing. Anyways, there's nothing maybe, hold on. Is there something I can do with that? Actually, no, this area is clear. Oh, wait, shit. Okay, now it's following me. Grab. Okay, hold on. No, please, leave me alone. Looks like I found it. There's not more water coming out. Okay, Jesus Christ. Guys, I'm just trying to get through. Okay. Alright. It's kind of spooky. What's our health looking like right now? Caution. Depending on what other enemies we're facing around here, which I think is going to be more dogs. Think we'll be fine for the time being. But if I take a couple more hits, or maybe like one more hit, I'll definitely try to heal, because that's just kind of spooky. Okay, there's a square-shaped hole here. So let's go ahead and put out a crank. And crank it up. I see a pool over there, so I can't really go under the pool. Can hear the sound of a waterfall in the distance. Well, that's what that did. And we still keep it just in case we need to put the water back again. Okay. So that's nice. I remember. Oh, God. I'm not gonna like this. Okay. I think I remember the kind of enemies we're gonna be dealing with in this particular, just this one area. Okay. Hold on. Oh, maybe not now? Okay, not now, but soon enough, we'll be dealing with some things around here. Okay. Yeah, so it looks to me like the dogs won't actually bite. That's gross here. Okay. Guys, don't mind me. Look, I'm just wandering around. Okay, now fuck that. Still just a normal caution. Okay. Yeah, we'll take the green herb. Yeah, okay, so there's crows actually going around now. Alright, hold on. The barrier has been taken out, that means we can't use the elevator, that's why they're okay, cool. Good to know. I'll use this information for later, maybe potentially some kind of transparent creature is swimming. What? Maybe there's a transparent creature swimming around in the water. What is that? Okay, anyways, it's a waterfall, a raging waterfall. There's something behind the waterfall, actually. Yeah, there's something beyond it, but because the water is going, we can't go through. And we can't put the water out, I mean back out, because then we can't go through the thing, you know. I know there's something here. There is definitely something here. Oh shit. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go ahead and use this. Because I know I've taken a fair amount of damage, so now I can take these red herbs. Combine you with that, and then we can combine that with that. So now we have made a mixture of green, blue, and red herbs. Also, I didn't actually examine the blue herbs. Next time we get some, I'll examine some more. Also, I did see those blue herbs growing back there, but I didn't bother picking them up. Anyways, blue herbs, they heal poison. Which means, yeah, because you guys remember from the, like, manual that we read about herbs the other day. Okay, yeah, they heal poison, which means there are things that can okay, they're like that. Those can poison you. Snakes. Alright, I thought we were gonna be fighting dogs in here, but I was mistaken. I actually kind of prefer the snakes, despite the fact that they can poison you, because they're kind of easy to dodge. Okay, cool, nothing here. Anyways, where are we right now? Residence. Is it the evil residence? Ha! That's the name of the game. Anyway, hold on. Water. Okay, we need a save point. Hi, there's some more blue herbs in here. I'll take them. Take the blue herb. Yes, I will. But, we only have one space left, so I might actually hold off on these other herbs for now. Anything? Oh, okay. What's in here? Well, first of all, we actually have to check which rooms are open and which ones are not. Okay, that's the kind of music I like to hear. Take the ingram, sure I will. And there's something else here. The berry pack. Okay, so we can escape more. Alright. And I did see the first aid spray, so don't worry about that. Okay, let's put this with that. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring this, and then I'm gonna bring these. Okay, hold on. Combine that with that. And then I know there's two more blue herbs out there, so I'll bring these two. Okay. Let me just go out real quick to grab those other blue herbs so I can combine them. And I'll actually examine one of them to show you guys that they do indeed heal poison. Okay. Let's grab these. We'll take the blue herb. And will you take the blue herb? Yes, I will. Okay. So let's examine that. An herb that grows wild in this region. Doesn't actually tell you anything, but again, from the manual, you would know that it heals poison. And by itself, a blue herb will only heal poison. It won't... Any amount of damage you've taken won't be healed by it. So that's why you combine it with other herbs to make, you know, stuff that neutralizes poison and what have you. Okay, so we've been recording for 20 minutes and we have entered a new place now. We also got passed through Lisa. So, hold on. We have done a fair amount of progress, so I think what I'm getting at here is that this might be a good time to save. Also, let me put this over here instead. And I kind of like... kind of like this sort of chemistry going on here. Okay. Okay, and we won't be needing the Magnum right now. So, shotgun, grenade launcher. Let me bring this. Okay, so hold on. No, that's not what I meant to do. Hold on, shit. Okay. Get the Magnum, put it down here, actually. Because I think there is one more type of grenade that we can get, so I want to leave that space open. And... okay. We won't be needing the crank right now, so... put it over here. And... yeah, I'm gonna use this one last shot I have on this shotgun. But... oh, there's just some random green arrows here. Hold on, let me put this up here. Okay, but before we use this shotgun, I'm gonna put in my fuel canteen and my lighter, because I do believe there may be some zombies around here. Okay, and then put just... actually, I think I'm not gonna bring any healing items with me until I start straying too far from where we are. And then I'll go and grab some, but otherwise, I'm just gonna grab my... what's the name? Ingrivance, and save. So all the time, writer, you can save your progress. Stingriven, sure. So let's see. Let's save over here. It's a little bit early to be saving, I know, but I will be fine. It's not a big deal. We have plenty of saving stuff left, and I do kind of like to be going into a new place, kind of prepared for it. That makes any sense. Okay, so yeah, that's what we're bringing with us right now. No healing items, because the save room is right here, so if I get injured, I can safely come back here without being through it. Anyways, I'm late, long story, but I'm here. How much did I miss? So welcome to the stream. You did miss us meeting Lisa, the chain monster thing, unfortunately. That was pretty spooky. But don't worry, we didn't kill her. She almost killed us and we just ran away from her. And otherwise, I've gone to the courtyard and we are now in like a garden residence place. That's all you've missed. But don't worry, again, we will meet Lisa again later. Alright, it's locked. Door plate reads 001. Alright, so we'll need to... hi. Let me see something here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I don't want to step on those cracks. Yeah, I figured I did. I really wanted to see that, but I'll check out the archive later. Yeah, it happens pretty early in the studio. Also, we got a Magnum gun, which is a high. Okay, no, this is a giant spider. It's not mess with that one. Says leave that one alone. I don't want to deal anything with that. A rack full of wine bottles. They're all cheap vintages. Okay. A red oil lamp. It's not lit. Okay, so we need to light it up with... oh, I don't have the thing to light it up. What am I doing? Whoa, spiders. Yeah, that's pretty spooky. Okay, so now a strange silhouette hovers in the reddish light. It's like an eye or something. Could have some kind of meaning, potentially. Anyways. Yeah, so they kind of shoot poison. So we gotta be careful with that. I'm not sure if I want to take care of them. I mean, I have enough room to dodge, so I'm not too worried about them, actually. The partition is decorated with dishes. I have had enough of the creepy crawlies today. Spiders, snakes, fuzzy beats, I've had enough of them. I guess you've been dealing with a couple of them, I imagine. Alright, an advertisement for an arm wrestling contest. The winner will be named Chief of the Day for a raccoon police graffiti. Also, I believe there's another spider in here.
Okay, will you take a shotgun shell? Sure I will. What else around here? There's a couple of things here. You can't carry any more items. Okay. Hmm. And there's another thing here, hold on. Green oil lamp is not lit. Okay, let's light it up. Glad it's not the playing the game. It's not me playing the game right now. Yeah. I'm one of the few people that I think doesn't have arachnophobia. Like, I much prefer spiders over cockroaches, for starters. And as far as gameplay goes, I know that these enemies can be very dangerous, but when I have a lot of room to dodge them, I'm not too worried about them. So hang on, where are you exactly? This doesn't look related to the mansion at all. It's like, we're in like a garden house that's like in the courtyard of the mansion. This is a pretty big area. Like it's gonna be about half of the size of the mansion. So we're gonna be here a while still, but yeah, we are technically not in the, we're in the mansion's vicinity, but not the mansion itself. Anyway, so this is a different kind of eye looking thing. Okay. Anyways, I kind of want those things, but I don't have space for them, so... Where's the spider? I mean, I hear it, but, like, is it in front of the stairs or something? No, it's not. Well, actually, it kind of is. Oh, there it is. You coming down? Can you come down? Can you? Ah, yes, you can. Okay, cool. Wait, no, crap. No, it's not that way. I need to see, game. Okay. Just move along. I have to borrow you right now. Jesus. Alright. That's just... there's just an ass here. Just an ass on the wall. Cool. Anyways. Hope I don't get age restricted for that. An orange oil lamp. It's not lit. Okay, well, let's light that one up, too. A strange silhouette hovers on this orange light. Okay, so this one has, like, two eyelashes. They're all eyes, but they're different looking eyes. This camera angle is bullshit, one of my biggest problems with the Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. Really? Well, yeah, I guess fixed camera can be a little bit of an issue. Okay, so some billiard balls. 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. There doesn't seem to be anything significant about the order, but there's something strange about them. Okay, so I mean, maybe the, oh, hold on. So this one's orange, and it has those. Are you guys coming down? Oh, there's another spider, like right here. I didn't realize, like this one right here. I don't think it can do anything to us from there, but it's there. Maybe it can shoot poison into here, though. Anyways, so. The orange is 5, the green is 6, the red is 3. Huh. Anyways. Hey, Mr. Spider, come on over here and play around with me. We'll figure this billiards out together. There doesn't seem to be anything, so, yeah. I realize maybe I'm undermining the threat of these spiders. I do realize that. I hope no one minds it too much. Anyways, yeah, red is 3. Green is 6 and then orange is 5. I'll have to remember that. Can I do anything with this guitar? Can't do anything with the guitar. Okay. No, wait, hold on, I'm done here. Okay. And what's the other two? Okay, so blue is 2 and then purple is 4. I'll try to remember those, but they don't seem to be too important for the time being. Okay. Buddy, pal, I'm gonna... Ow! Hey! Not nice! Okay, you actually poisoned me. Fucking... Oh, no, fuck you. No, you don't just do that. Fuck you. Alright, now, hold on. Are you dead now? Okay, now you're aiming at the other one, right? Yeah, you are. Okay, so this one's dead. Fucking poison, Jesus Christ. Okay, guess we'll have to go take care of that real quick. Yeah. Another pin-up poster. What kind of house is this again? He just comes off looking like an ordinary bar. I believe this is the, I should have probably not combined all those orbs, now that I think about it. We're gonna go back to those blue orbs that were back there. Anyways, we are... going to go back to the blue orbs. Anyways, what I'm gonna say is that we are currently in, like, the residence where the employees of the mansion used to hang out. So... snakes. So that's basically the all those like sexy posters on the wall are basically just the decoration that they decided to put because it's their residence. They get to do what they wanted there. Their actual job is in the other place. Okay, so this. There are blue herbs growing here. Use them, sure. You have neutralized the poison in your body. Cool. So we're still fine, right? Okay, we're still fine. Alright, I just wanted to use that shotgun for, to use like the one shot it has left. I guess we did that now. Alright. I guess that was some kind of employee snakes! Employee lounge. Yeah. Okay, so we'll go back and drop off the obsolete shotgun, because no longer has any shots on it. And yeah. Okay. Yeah, the reason I didn't use the blue herbs that I had previously obtained to heal up those that poison is because I decided to combine them with all the with all of my other like what's the name of them? My red herbs, my super combined red herbs. So I didn't want to use a full heal just for that. Okay, but we're officially done with this shotgun. So now we can put you over here with the other broken shotgun. So we don't have to deal with you ever again. And let me bring this up here. And now I'm just gonna grab one of these green herbs. And actually, I'm not. No, not yet. Like again, I'll come back here if I need to. But we're fine right now. I'm quite sick of snakes. There's a black razor hiding in our garage right now, and we can't figure out how to get rid of it. Yeah, I think I know what you mean. I've never had to deal with too many snakes myself, but I did have one snake almost bite me when I was a kid. That was not fun. Not fun at all. But I didn't get bitten by it, so thankfully I'm fine. Alright, but yeah, I'm not sure. I hope you guys are okay over there. Alright. Okay. So we need to use this box to, like, hold on, like right there, to cover that hole down there, otherwise bad things will come out of it. And yeah. Okay, cool. I can climb up it. Keep going over here. Climb some more. And climb down. And then climb down again. Okay. Been streaming for about 34 minutes. So far, so good. Again, I do have a couple of new settings for recording today. So I hope everything looks fine so far. Nothing too terrible. It doesn't seem to be anything useful. That's unfortunate. Okay, what else around here? Alright. They're not supposed to be dangerous, but it just skeeves me out of knowing that it's going to be there every time I go out to grab a soda or something out of sight. Yeah, that's I understand the feeling of having a snake in your place being pretty annoying. Anyways, what did I say? Newspaper lies scattered about. They all seem to contain articles about stars. And remember, Jill is a stars member, so that's concerning. Okay. Anyways, there's some notes here. Can I do anything with that? Nope. Okay. About this one. Alright. Before exploring these doors, I'm gonna see what's going on over here. 002. Okay, good to know. There's a map of the residence. Take it. Sure. Why wouldn't I? Okay, so there's definitely a few more items here. Oh yeah, should I have to go back to the billiards place. Yeah, the map of the residence. There's a hole in the wall here. Well, it's good to know. If probably be needing that hole later. It wouldn't be there if the game wasn't going to point it out. Okay. Yeah, let me go back to the billiards room and grab the few items that I missed. If there's any difference in graphical quality, you'd be the better judge of it. I'm very tired, so I can't perceive fine details right now anyways. I compared the test recordings that I did today to what we're looking at right now. I mean, to what we're looking at yesterday. And, like, they look a little bit more pixelated, a little bit blurrier, but it's barely noticeable. And if the stream is already not high definition anyway, so it's not really much of a concern. Like, will you take the red book? Sure, I will. And will you take the first aid thing? Sure, I will. Okay, so now we're not done here yet. Or we are, never mind. Okay, so let's examine this thing. I'm not entirely sure. Oh, never mind, that's something else. A herb of mixed green and blue. A herb mix of green and blue herb was inside. I could have used this earlier. I need to go all the way back to heal. Okay, whatever. Okay, so that's what a blue and green herb looks like. Okay, and how about this? Bandage with blood. It's a book with a red cover. That's weird. Okay, what's inside? Nothing. It's a book with a red cover. Nothing is printed on any of the pages. Is there a special way to use it? Well, now we know. It is an unprinted book. Has no contents to speak of. Okay, whatever. Let me just go back up here to remember the, what were the, these things. Okay, so again, orange is 5, green is 6. Also, there's something under the 6. It's like a smiley face or something. I'm not sure, but anyways, and 3 is red. Okay. Dip it in blood? I don't know. maybe dipping the book about blood in blood will do something. Oh, I wanted to find a blood pool for that also. Yeah, there's definitely... I get the feeling that there were like no female employees over here in this facility. It's very male oriented, and it also helps that we haven't encountered any female zombies. It's weird, but whatever. Okay, I guess they had some kind of male only rules going on. Then again. Again, I said earlier that I was playing Resident Evil 0 earlier, and it said over there that the people that work here do not discriminate by gender, race, or orientation, or anything like that. You're like, anyone is welcome to work at this corporation. Now, like, well, it seems to be all dudes. Now, what's your deal? Okay, can I come in here? It's locked. The door plate reads gallery. Okay, so we'll need the gallery key for this. What's the time period again? During a certain age of American businesses, the entire workplace was related as a four-man environment, regardless of how many female employees were present. This game is set on July of 1998.
No, that wasn't part of our deal. Like I said, but it's not necessary to destroy stars. About my family. If I play my cards right.
Well, that was interesting. There's some weird things going on over here. Let's go in. What's going on? Someone in here would like to enlighten me on the situation?
Jill.
Barry, I heard someone talking.
Oh, you heard. I think age is starting to take its toll. Talking to myself is becoming a bad habit.
Talking to yourself? You all right? What's gotten into you?
I'm getting you worried, aren't I? But don't, I'm all right. I guess this creepy mansion has gotten to my nerves. Anyway, I think I'll go outside, get some fresh air for a change. Don't worry. I'm just going to get some fresh air. If I'm lucky, I'll get to waste some monsters along the way.
Barry, you are like putting... If there's like a checklist of everything you can do to sound suspicious, you just did all of them, Barry. Also, going to get fresh air in a mansion infested with zombies and similar creatures? Yeah, no kidding. Bad fucking idea, Barry. You should be looking for a... If you are tired, go to a safe room. There are no monsters in those. And you stay there until you recover your energy. Then go out. There's no time for fresh air. Anyways, Plan 42 report. 4 days have passed since the accident. The plant at Point 42 is growing at an amazing rate. Although there are many unknown aspects about this plant, we know that in comparison with the other group of plants, the T-virus has had a substantially stronger effect on this one. The T-virus has drastically morphed its host's anatomy as well as its size. Looking at its current state, it's difficult to imagine its original appearance. Nowhere on Earth will you find anything like it. We've also found that Plant 42 has two main sources of acquiring its necessary nutrients. One source is through its root. Somehow, it has rooted itself down into the basement. Immediately after the accident, a scientist went mad and destroyed the aqua rink. Ever since, the basement has been like a pool. There is a high possibility that it's one of the chemicals in the water that's promoting the Plant 42's rapid growth. However, we have yet to determine the specific chemical. A bulb-like body of the Plant 42 has been sighted hanging from the ceiling of the first floor. We are sure that it's used to the air conducts to reach the first floor. Numerous long tentacles, like vines, are protruding from the bulb. We believe the vines are the second means of acquiring its nutrients. When the Plant 42 senses prey, it uses the tentacle-like vines to capture its prey. After doing so, it suckers on the vine, drain, and pray for its blood. We've also noticed that it has some intelligence. When it captures its prey or when it's active, the vines twine around the door to stop possible intruders. Unfortunately, several of our scientists have already fallen victim to this Plant 42 when we heard the stories from the survivors. They all observed one thing in common. When the uniform petal-like flaps open and reveals its vital internals, it has a tendency to become more aggressive. One witness reported that it was as if it was trying to protect itself. Why it behaves the way it does is still unknown. May 21st, 1998. Henry Sarton. Well, some kind of spooky stuff going on. Sounds like a boss fight to me, honestly. And some tips. When it opens its weak point, it's going to start attacking more, so now we know. Plan 42. I've read about this, but I've never seen it in the game before. Yeah, it's... Well, now you know what it might look like, and then we will definitely know what it will look like. Anyways, I did not read that. Hold on. All newspapers and magazines lie on top of the bed. Someone appears to have vomited blood on some of the newspaper. That's not good. It's not good at all. There's nothing special. Sure, chill. I don't know. Maybe there is something special. You're just not looking at it. Hold on. There's something here. One of these books is special. Hold on. Not? Yeah, okay, well, never mind. Jesus. Hold on. Okay, so let's see. Can I, like... so I can push this back here. Anything over here? Nope. And can I push this, like, to this? Actually, no. I think we can just push it, like, here, maybe? If it can be pushed, that means there's something behind it. Ah! There's a ladder back here. Climb it down. Well, okay, we're not gonna climb it down yet because I believe there's still one door that we haven't explored. Actually, this right here is a door we haven't explored. Never mind. Okay. So. Something I should be aware of here. Let's see. I hear something. Well, another bathtub. I've had bad experiences with this in this game, so okay, is there anything else I should be aware of here? Water drips from the sink? Perhaps the valve is broken. Oh, there's a key here. Oh, hi! Oh, hi! I knew I heard something! I thought it was gonna be coming from the... Back off! Jesus Christ. Okay, now I'm gonna... Seriously. Fucking hell. Okay. I hate this freaking guys. Alright, hold on, let me thankfully I brought this along, so I do believe I'm gonna be having to come back. Not to the bathroom, but since I know zombies can open doors, I'm just gonna go ahead and play it safe. Burn this guy. Okay, cool. Now is there anything in the bathtub? There is not. Alright. Whatever. I hate when zombies do that. And you know what's the stupidest thing? I don't think zombies will ever do that through a locked door. So, they will never unlock a door for you. Which is just unfortunate. Also, there's bloodstains on that door. Alright. Bedrooms are the worst in these horror games. No kidding. Alright. Even Luigi's Mansion had some tense encounters in the bathrooms. It's locked. Okay, so this was the gallery. Alright, well... Hold on. Is there any other door I should be aware of? Doesn't seem like it. Okay, so we're gonna go back to the save point and... There's some dead plants in here. Just realized. I mean, it makes sense for there to be dead plants, but... Just look kind of grim. Just like everything in this game, it looks kind of grim. Alright. Yeah, we're gonna stop by the save room so we can... Drop and pick up a couple of things. Alright. And we can't go through the side of these doors because these boxes because there's that hole over there. So now that we're at our plan 42 is down there, it'll grab us, and that's just no fun for anyone. Okay. So let's see. What am I gonna need for this? I don't actually remember what exactly we're gonna be dealing with down there. There's still plenty of kerosene. Okay, your field of heal canteen. Okay. Cool. Speaking of Luigi's Mansion, I wonder how much of its design was inspired by Resident Evil. Does this mansion have stuff like... let's see. Hold on. I don't think I'm gonna be needing this book right now, but I'll leave it over here. Also, I'm not gonna be needing this right away. So I'm gonna be dropping it over... We have a lot of green herbs. Actually, let me show you guys something you can do. You can actually combine two green herbs and one blue herb, and it'll make that. Make sure two green herbs and one blue herb, so it'll heal you pretty good and also heals poison. Oh, that's not what we're gonna be using right now. Okay, so just drop that off. Over here. And we're not gonna use the first aid spray. We're gonna use our green herbs, because we still have three more of them, so... Cool. A film projector room, a room with a huge mirror, or an observatory. I'm pretty sure all three of those things are... Okay, at least two of those are in this game, and one of them might be in a different Resident Evil game, but definitely a film projector room, a room with a huge mirror, and an observatory. They're all in the Resident Evil series. Okay. And I'll combine that with that. Okay. Also, what's this say again? There's nothing unusual, but we read this side, and there's numbers imprinted 001. Okay, cool. And actually, we're gonna be dropping this again over here. I'll come pick it up in a bit, but well, actually, no, it's fine. Not because we're gonna use that key right away, anyways. Okay. And there's nothing else in here, right? Like, this room is clear. Okay, yes, it is. I have a feeling we're gonna be fighting a couple more zombies. So, definitely wanna keep my kerosene bottle around. Okay, so you are 001. There's no further use for this key, discard it, share. Alright. Anything I should be aware of? Let's see. Ah, yes, what is that? Something moving on the corner over there, but I can't tell what it is. But it seems to be doing the same exact motions. I don't think it's a zombie. Alright, anyways. Wow, those were the most obscure things I could think of from Luigi's Mansion. I thought those were a bit weird to have in a mansion. Yeah. Anyways. Then again, remember, this is also an observatory, not just a mansion. The fuck was that? Jesus Christ, what the fuck was that? Okay, I'm just gonna go ahead and burn this guy. And I'm not okay with the sound I just heard. I don't know what it was. Sure, pull the plug, why not? What's gonna happen? There's something inside the bathtub. That's oh no. Look at the size of that key! It's gigantic! My god! Okay. Alright, sure, whatever. Let's take the fucking, like, shotgun-sized control room key. Let's give her into the control room. Okay. Alright. Okay, anyways. Again, I'm still concerned about that noise. It's the size of Jill's entire poem. Yeah, there's gotta be a big freaking door if we're admitting that for it. Okay, so is there like a zombie here now or something? I hope it's just a zombie if it was. Hold on. Wasn't there like something over here? Ah, there's a zombie here. Okay, hold on. Okay, hold on, fuck. Jesus Christ, why? That guy has a noose on him. That zombie has a, like, suicide noose on him. Well, okay. Still, that is a zombie we just killed, so let me just burn him up. Okay. So we are now in caution status. That's not good, but... not what I'm gonna do, but, we can take, like, maybe one more hit. Alright. That wiggy thing isn't there anymore. So the second was... so the sound was this new zombie falling to the floor? Ah, maybe. Yeah, I guess if we had explored this first, maybe that guy would have been hanging here. And then the sound would have been him falling. Man, I wish we had explored the rest of this first before going into the bathroom. I'm an idiot. Okay, whatever. What else is in here? There's like a thing here. Hold on. Ah, more handgun ammo. So I don't feel bad about wasting the ammo, but I do feel bad about the kerosene, though, because kerosene is kind of... You take the self-defense gun? Sure. So, suicide note. There it is. June 22nd, 1998. I had to do it. Ran from those things, helping each other to survive. But Robert started to show the symptoms. I had to do it. Those damn things, pure evil. There was no other way. He would have done the same if it were the other way around. After I put him out of his misery, I had to just leave him in the bedroom. Now I'm probably the last one. Well, that's... so we just killed Robert. Now good to know. And, how could this happen? I'll never forgive myself for being part of this project. Eventually I'll get what's coming to me, though. There's no way to escape from this nut house. It's just a matter of time now. Everything is set. All I need is a little courage to get it done. Knowing that I'll leave many things undone is regret beyond words. But this is better than just wanting to turn into one of them. Please understand, at least let me end my life as a person. There's a message in the back. Linda, please forgive me. And it says right there, Linda, I don't want to die, but you had to die anyways. So, well, do get used to those. Suicide notes are basically like every other file in the Resident Evil series, so yeah, we're gonna be seeing a lot of those, not just in this game, but like in other games as well. Anyways, an old bookcase. Well, how much was that say? He looked like he might have been blocking the way if that wiggly thing from before was also hanging the zombie. Yeah, I guess so. Note to self, hanged men are not immune to zombification. Yeah, like, again, the only thing that will actually kill, prevent them from becoming zombies is burning and getting their brains blown out. So, he might have had a broken neck, but he still had a brain, so that was enough to become a zombie. The books are mostly concerned with literature and philosophy. Yeah. Anyways, what else is around here? Actually, are we done? Oh yeah, we're done here. Okay, well, there were resources and a key, so that was worthwhile. Alright. But, we are kind of injured now, so... Hold on, what do we have on this? Okay, this thing, I forgot. Okay, so, a self-defense gun that fires 0.22 magnum rounds. One round has been fired already. Well, I see two. Jill, what do you mean one round has been fired? There are clearly two bullets in there. I'm not blind. Yeah, I do wear glasses, but I'm not fucking blind. I see that. Whatever. Okay, anyways. Let's go back in here, refill our kerosene tank. Put away the mini magnum. Because we're not going to be needing it right away. And maybe we can heal. Okay. Yeah, so let's drop this off. Like, down here, I guess. And for now, yeah, I'm just gonna grab like two of these. Because I just have a bunch of them laying around. Combine that with that, then use that. Okay, now I still have a full heal on me. That's nice. We have the control room key, so we have to find the control room. And yeah. Can you equip that thing? It almost looks like it's a fossil item. No, it's a gun, you can equip it. I don't believe that there are any puzzles with it. But yeah, we'll find something to use it on eventually. Alright. Maybe we could one shot that spider that's over in that billiards room. If it starts bothering us. Okay. Anyways. So there's still that ladder that we haven't explored yet, so that's what we're gonna do now. Alright. I believe it was over here. Okay. And what else? I don't believe there's anything else here, right? No, okay, so I think we've explored every room in here so far and cleared it out. At least all the ones that we have explored, we've cleared them out. This ladder here. Climb down? Sure. Okay, so what's gonna be at the bottom of this? I don't know. Well, this doesn't look very... Residence-like. I mean, we're just in like a normal residential house. Now we're in like... an underground facility. That's... strange. Okay. Cool. Let's see. There's a box here. Another box here. And another box and... oh, okay. So, can't go through there. Also, there's a consistent fog effect going on here. Alright, so I think what we have to do is push these boxes into that thing. Alright. Alright. I turned away for a second. Are you playing Half-Life now? Yeah, we climbed down the ladder and we are now in like an underground water facility. So, yeah. It was a bit of a jarring transition, but it happened. Okay. Alright. Almost there. Come on. So this puzzle was in the original Resident Evil. But there is a bit of a difference that I particularly remember. This box in the original Resident Evil is like over here. So you have to push it way further in the original like PS1 Resident Evil. So in the remake they put it a little bit closer. However, this door over here to the right, that was not there. So that's new. We'll have to come back here later. Well, for now, he's gonna keep pushing this box so we can make a pad on that water thing. Also, it is very convenient that these boxes actually float. Like, technically speaking, if we were applying real-life physics to this, there is a possibility that one, at least one of these boxes doesn't float, which would make going to this like little self-made bridge here a little bit more difficult. But that's not the case, so that's cool. We can just go through. It's fine, no problem. Here is an herb. Congratulations on your efforts. Here's a healing item. Okay, cool. Ow. Water. Ow. Oh. Shit. I know what's on the other side. Let me go back and save real quick. I'll be right back. Hold on, I need to go do something here. Alright. Let's stop by the freaking save room real quick, because I know what's behind that door, and I don't think I have the right things for it. Also, I would like to save before we go in that place. Okay. So let's see. Keep going over here. I must mention, every time I go back through here, like, I know it's Jill's shadow. I mean, not shadow, her reflection on the window. But it spooks me. Like, I keep thinking there's something on the other side. It's not, it's just Jill's reflection. Jesus. Alright, anyways. Okay. I know it's a little bit of a long way back, but I do know what we're gonna be dealing with once we go to that door. And I want to be ready for it. And I have the right items. A saved game. Okay. Let's drop these herbs over here and then grab that one, put it down here. Okay. Change the handgun for a shotgun and the shotgun shells. And let's save. Okay. I was thinking the exact same thing. It makes me think that there's like super fast zombies on the other side of the window. Yeah, it's an old typewriter. Okay, you can save your progress. Yeah, thankfully there are no... I believe the only... There's only like two obligatory Crimson Head zombies in this game, which is the one that we found like at the beginning of the game with those... from the guy that was just laying on that hallway for a long time. And then the one that you actually have to fight as a boss fight. Otherwise, I think that's about it. Alright. I think we're ready now. We're not gonna be needing this. So let me drop them off over here. Oh, what if we find? Oh yeah. I would like to have space. Okay. Let's see. And if we do encounter any zombies, I thankfully have my shotgun on me so I can just decapitate them by shooting them in the head. So that's cool. Crimson Heads are scary, but I don't think any of them move as fast as, say, a Half-Life 2 fast zombie. Yeah, I guess that might be right. Though, then again, Half-Life is a much more action-packed head. Action-packed game, so... Yeah. Though, obviously, the later Resident Evil games, like 4, 5, and 6, the ones that are a lot more action-packed than the original ones... They have pretty fast enemies in them, so way down the line, once we get to those Resident Evil games, you'll meet some pretty quick, devastating enemies. But for now, we're just gonna be playing the older, spookier games, which are my personal favorites. I much prefer the older, spooky Resident Evil games as compared to the newer action games. Though Resident Evil 7 did kind of try to go back to the formula. Okay, are we gonna get a cutscene here? Let's see. No, we're not. Okay, we're just here. Alright, I don't like water. Not in horror games specifically. Anyways, hold on, what does that say? Yeah, this would be a very different game if you were given the ability to shoot chainsaw blades to decapitate zombies. Yeah, definitely. Okay. So yeah, there's sharks here. I'm not a fan. Not a fan of them at all. And I'm not gonna be dealing with them. No, no, fuck you. You are way too close. Also, you clip through the fucking railways. Okay. Alright, hold on. No, please get me out of here. Okay. We are now in high ground, but that doesn't mean they can't reach us. Okay, here's a control room key. Cool, there's no further use for this key. Let's guard it. Yes, please. Now get me out of here. Alright, cool. So, those sharks are called Neptunes. And, or maybe, I'm not sure, but anyways. They clip to everything. Yeah, they just don't even give a shit. Okay, so, Neptunes are a bit of a big deal. And by, I don't mean big, quite literally. Look at that guy. That guy's extra big. Okay, so hold on, let me see something here. First aid kit here, let me go ahead and get that. I was half expecting the giant plant to be in the middle of that room, didn't expect sharks. Yeah, the game told us about the plant, it didn't tell us about the sharks though. Okay, so what's in this one? Another mix of two winners was inside. Sure, I'll take it. Now we have more healing items. Okay, so an oil pressure regulator. There's no need to adjust the pressure right now. And there's some... There's a light, but we can't do anything with the light. That's cool. What is around here? Okay, so... There's water on the other side, so... Can't go through. Well, let me get some... Speaking of water, let me drink some water. Alright, the door is held tightly shut by the pressure of the water. So we'll need to bring the water down for this to work. Okay, so... What else is around here? Caution! In case of a drop in oil pressure control, open valve number 2. Okay, so... If we drop the oil pressure, we'll need to grab the thing. Okay, so there's an aqua ring map here. There's not a whole lot going on, but... Do have a couple of floors. By a couple, I mean literally two. We are currently in the second bottom floor. And we've pretty much explored everything up there, but okay. You got the map of the aqua ring. Okay, so valve number 2, gotta remember that. And anything I can do with that? Nope, doesn't seem like it. Okay, so what's going on here? A pressure shelter. Okay. The controls for the main system. Everything seems to be in proper working order. Okay. An error message is being displayed. Something appears to have gone wrong while the water was being drained. There's a switch on the drain water. Press it? No. Because knowing this game, whenever I start solving a puzzle, things go downhill real fast. Okay, a pressure shelter. That guy's too spooky. Okay, I think we've explored everything that there is in this room, so let's go ahead now. Okay, so there's a switch, drain the water, sure. Oh crap!
Emergency, emergency, unknown source of pressure detected. Locking all doors to achieve maximum safety.
Well, it's not actually locking the door, so that's a problem. There's a control lever for the pressure shield. From boards until the safety is released. Okay, so Hey, stop that! Stop that! Okay, hold on. Pressure shelter is locked. Release the safety. Yes, release the safety. Okay, so maybe the pressure has been released.
30% of pressure threshold.
Okay, now can we do this one? Alright. Cool. Okay, we're closed. Shit. Restore all pressure, dead, release safety. Okay, valve number 2. Where's valve number? Is what is?
Reaching 50% of
the switch is control panel. Press the switch number 2. Okay, cool. Now try again. Hold on. Shit. 50%. Game. Okay, now can I do this again? Oh shit. No, fuck. Okay, now this one. Oh crap. Oh shit. Okay, now hold on. Yes, release safety. Okay. Try again. Stop
Dude, stop! I'm in here! I know you, I don't taste good, I swear. Jail sandwiches are not as tasty as you might imagine. Please close the door. Please, actually, okay, go. Okay. Okay, we're safe now. Nice. What now? Can I, how do I put the water down? Hold on. Oh shit. Well, we better not open that door again. The safety has been released. Drain the water. Yes, please! Drain the water. I don't want these sharks to have breathing room. Alright. How did they even get these sharks all the way out to this underground marine research facility in the woods? That was a pretty tense little segment. Yeah. I'm gonna guess that they... I'm going to first of all guess that these sharks were a lot smaller before they were mutated. And then they found some kind of way to transport them here. But anyway, are we done here? Okay, yeah, we're done here. So now, because the water has been drained, we can go back up and explore freely because there are no longer sharks up here. That's nice. Okay. So let's see. Now that I can more calmly explore. Oh hi, there's still sharks. It's just not alive. Hey, stop that. Okay. Okay, no. Hey, quit it. Look, I'm just trying to explore the area. You can't move. Alright, whatever. As long as we don't get close to its mouth, we're alright. Alright. Any more sharks around here? No, you're just aiming at that one over there. Okay, cool. So yeah, as long as we don't get close to the mouth of that one, we should be fine. We don't need to waste ammo on it. Don't think there's anything else in here. Okay, so... there's no point in keeping exploring over there. Anything else? No, but you can aim really far. Like, that thing's almost on the other side of the room and she's still aiming at it. Yeah, that's good aim, Jill. But anyways, is there actually anything else around here? Doesn't seem like it. Okay, so we're able to open that, but there's no more reason to do anything up here, so I guess we'll go down. Hold on. Is there really nothing else? Oh, I feel like... well, yeah, it is actually cleared. Okay, I guess we're done. Alright, so now we gotta go... go back down and open that other door that was being held closed by the pressure of the water. Okay. So this one over here. Okay, also I realized that I brought in a shotgun with me to fight sharks with. And now I realize that I haven't actually fought a single one of them. I found ways to not have to. Okay, so what is this? Oh, I can actually go through here. Not good to know that this door isn't locked. But... hold on. Oh! I know what those are. I'll come back for you later, though. Because I need to explore the rest of that other room. Let me get some water. First, too. Now that we've drained the water, let me refill my own water supply. Hey! Okay, so what else is around here? It's quiet. Oh, there's another room in here. What's going on over here? Oh, well, okay. More places to explore. Okay, let me finish exploring this room, and then I'll go to other rooms. Okay, so diving suits and nets. There doesn't seem to be anything of use. Also, all of this shit was just underwater. Like, really? Are you sh-
It was just like a maintenance room underwater. Oh, hello. I didn't see that. Take the grenade shell? Sure I will. Damn, that's nice. Okay, materials labeled dynamite. They're soaked beyond use. Well, I'm glad the dynamite can no longer be used. Against my well-being. Alright. I guess they probably used the dynamite to kill the sharks if they got out of control. But I feel like the sharks ended up killing them instead. An experimental monitor. Looks like it was being used to gather data on sharks. I don't know, please don't take a diving suit. I don't want to sit through Resident Evil all over again. Alright, yeah, there's another shark over there. Are you alive? Well, she's aiming at him, so yeah, I guess so. Okay. Can I go through you without... Are you like exactly where I need to be? No, I can go through. I almost feel bad for it. Like, put it out of its misery kind of bad for it, but yeah, we're fine. Okay, so what is around here? Oh, there's the big one. Oh, there is the big one. Okay, so... Also, there's a bit more water over there. She's not actually aiming at him, though. Yeah, she's still aiming at the other one. Okay, I am... I'm not sure if I should be in the water with this thing, but okay. I imagine it making Magikarp noises every time it lumps. You have no idea what they're used for. Okay. Please, I'm gonna try to not come too close to it. Okay. Yeah, just get up this thing. Okay, cool. Okay, I see an item in here. Oh, hi. No, hey. Okay, I'm not calming down there. But, alright, let's see. The water fuel flow control system. It doesn't have power. And how do we give it power? Well, that's an issue. Generator used for a water flow control system? Well, there, sure. Ow! Well, okay, that shark won't be a problem anymore. Now, for sure, it is dead. Okay, well, okay, still twitching. Stop twitching. I am not coming down or just stop twitching. Or maybe that's just the electricity making its body move, but its actual brain is dead. I'm gonna hope it's that one. Anyways, what else? Oh, I didn't even think that I was a real shark at first. Alright, so this thing is toasted. Oh, you actually said it's toasted! And you're for the water flow control, it's toasted! That is such a 90s thing to say! Okay, now it stopped twitching. Alright, cool. So now I feel a lot safer about coming down here and... we can even go inside its... Look, we're inside its body! Now it's... You know an enemy is dead when you can just walk into it. Alright, residence key. Cool. Nothing else over here, though. Anything else? Nope, we're good. Alright, cool. I'll never be dealing with you again. Okay, so what's this one say? The world's gallery is pretty... Ah, okay, so this is the gallery key. I know where the gallery is, so we'll come back to that in a bit. And you, I have to walk through you, like, from over... Hey, stop. You're just making this harder on yourself, buddy. I'm telling you. Okay, whatever. Alright, I think I grabbed every item down here. Yep, okay, we're done. I didn't have to waste a single shot. I was preparing myself for, like, shark boss fights and, like, to fight a bunch of... I could have come down here with a fucking knife. And I would have been A-okay. Would have been A-okay with just a freaking knife. Alright, whatever. We're done with this area. So... come out through here, see what we get. Okay, so... Will you take the Magnum rounds? Yes, I will! So, this is what we'll be putting on the Magnum once we need to start using it. The materials have been piled on top of each other by the overflowing water. And the material. Oh, yeah, I know. Okay. Is there anything else here? Nope. Okay, we're done. So now I can come up here and see what's over here. Alright. This is our room. Oh, hold on. Oh, I get it. Okay, this is the room. On the other side of this is like the pool where we put those boxes into to make that bridge. Okay, so by logic would dictate, this room right here is the one that was locked. At least, again, logic would dictate. That's what's on the other side of this. Yeah. Okay, cool. Anyways, we are completely done with this area from what I see. Yeah, so we have no reason to come back here. Or, hold on. Wait, there's a room down there. That's a room I didn't explore. Okay, hold on. I didn't realize that there is a room I have not explored. I'll go back to pick that up real quick. Again, it's always a good thing to double check your map, just in case you missed something. Yeah, there might be a key item in there, or maybe just some supplies. But either way, I want whatever's in it, unless it's zombies, which I don't think there's any. Okay, maybe, I don't know. Either way, I'm going to come in here. Where did I go? Okay. Yeah, okay, good, I get it. Alright, so there was a reason to go into that aqua ring on the top floor. I just didn't see it. I'm blind. Then again, since all of these are pre-rendered backgrounds, any sort of, like, key rooms, anything like that, kind of blends in with the rest of the environment. So, it's hard to tell, but that is also what makes this game kind of unique. That's cool. Okay, so there's a room in here somewhere. Oh, yeah, there is. I didn't even see that. Wow. In hindsight, Deep Fear, the Resident Evil, seems like... Oh, hi! Plant 42? Hold on, what does that say? In hindsight, Deep Fear, Resident Evil seems like a much... Seems like such garbage compared to the game it was inspired by. I guess so. Okay, I don't want to get close to that. So, I'ma just know. I now know. There's not even anything in this room. What? Actually, can I get close to it? I'm curious. How? I can just... It's not even doing anything. Is there... Oh, wait. Okay, I get it. So... Yeah, we can just face through it. It doesn't feel us. For some reason. Also, I imagine Japan had a lot of fun with making the tentacle monster. I'm just pointing it out there. Anyways, now we know this is where the root of Plant 42 is. So we'll come back to that later. I'll take the aqua ring segment over anything from the big table. Seems way more fun. Yeah, I guess so. Okay, so now we know that the root of Plant 42 is down here in the aqua ring. So if we get something to kill Plant 42 with, we'll come back to that. Otherwise, yeah. Okay, cool. So, well, now we're actually done here, so we'll just come back to... What's the name of it? What was I gonna say? Yeah, we'll come back to the residence now we have the gallery key. Been recording for almost an hour now. I think we can probably at least finish this, like, residential area. Just, like, the homes over here of the employees. Before we're done tonight. Okay, so yeah, that's That seems to be the goal for tonight. We're gonna finish this residence area, and then we'll call it a night for then. And next week we'll do whatever comes after this. Okay. Probably gonna have to come back to the mansion because there's still a bunch of locked rooms over there. Okay. Nothing here. Alright, good. Just making sure. And actually, I guess we can keep the shotgun. But there is something else I could use. How many shotgun shells do I have? Okay, hold on. Let me do something here real quick. Use the gallery key. There's no further use for this key. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drop by the safe room real quick so I can drop off a few items. Because I don't feel like I'm gonna be needing some of these anymore. Okay. Anyways. Drop down here. And down here. Okay, so kill the sharks, but Plan 42 is still the main concern here. So it's good to know. Also, we found no reports on the sharks or anything. I would have thought we would have found at least something on them, but I guess we didn't. Okay, so yeah, so because this already had grenade rounds loaded into it, you can just load them right in. But anyways, Magnum, put that over there, put that over here, I guess. I'm gonna bring this along with me, so just put it like over here. I know we have a bajillion first aid sprays, but this game actually has a score system. And using first aid sprays specifically brings down your score. So I'm going to avoid using them as much as I can. But if for whatever reason I completely run out of herbs and am forced to use first aid sprays, I'll go ahead and use them. But I'll try to be careful so that doesn't happen. Okay. Anyways, put the handgun back on. Let me get my fuel canteen, lighter, mixed herbs, and let me take my book with me, actually, just in case we end up finding where to use it. We're not gonna save yet, though. Okay. I'm gonna clear a couple more rooms, and then I might save. This is the first I've heard of such a system. Is there any reward for scoring high? Yes, there is! You might have seen it every time I save, but I do have a clear data when I first played this game with Chris. And so once you load that up, it's kind of like a new game plus system. And depending on how good your grade is and if you complete certain criteria, you can get some cool extra items on your next playthrough, like some new weapons and like costumes and stuff like that. So yeah, that's what you can. So you get a pretty good score on this game, you can get some extra items on New Game Plus. Alright. But we're not gonna be going for a high score, whatever score I get, that's what I get. I'm not here to be like a super pro Resident Evil player, because I'm not. Alright, hang on magazine. Oh hi, bees! Oh hi, bees! Hold on, no, wait, shit. Okay, please no, I don't like the bees. Okay, it's locked. The door blade is now 0-3. Okay, cool. We have Jesus. An assortment of all test tubes and flasks. Okay, how old are you? Game. Game. Oh, this is like the Telsus Symphonia then. Kind of. It's a weird comparison, but I mean, yeah, if you're looking for a new game plus system that rewards you afterwards, I guess so. Anyways, lockman, is it? Sure. Oh, hello. I know this. Okay, so that was orange. Orange was 5. Actually, no, never mind, it wasn't. No. Orange. No, this one was orange. That was green. Green was 6. Then 5, and then 3. Right? Oh, okay, I get it. Okay, never mind. 6. Then 5, then 3? What? No, wait, no. Wait, no, hold on, no. That's not what I meant. No, it is green. No, green is... No, that's orange. No, yeah, it's... Oh, no, wait, no, this is green. Oh, what am I doing? No, wait, but... Okay, that's orange. Orange is 5. Yes, okay, so green is 6. And then red is 3. Okay, there we go. I thought it was red, not pink, but whatever. Okay. Cool. Cockroaches, but they're not zombie cockroaches. Just normal cockroaches. Okay. What's in here? Yellow 6. You need a container to put it in. And there's a bunch of containers in this room. Okay. I do know what we need to do with this, but I don't have the notes for them yet. There's some mad things over here. 1 plus 3 equals 4, 4 plus 6 equals 10, 1 plus 6 equals 7, 10 plus 7 equals 17, 17 plus 3 equals 20. Okay, so we'll need to keep those notes around, but there is something else that I need to find first. Okay, so I know there's bees here. Can I come over here? No, but there is a red herb here. I'll take it. I'll take that one. Okay, I have bees. Okay, it's blocked from the other side. Okay, so we can. Hey. I'm getting bitten by this, right? Okay, no, I haven't. So we can't enter that one because it's locked, but. A corpse with a contorted expression of pain on his face. You can actually kind of see the, like the sting marks on all over his head. It's. Eh. That guy went pretty bad. Okay, he's holding something. Will you take the insect? Insecticide spray? Yes, I will. Okay. Hey, no. Bees. Okay, there's the bee's nest. Oh, hey, get off. It's too dangerous to go any further. Okay. Oh, wait, hold on. Jill, no. Fuck. Don't go towards it. Go away from it. Okay, hey, get off. Jesus. Alright, hold on. Here lies Stanley the Buckman. Okay, so what we're gonna do... You guys remember that hole that we uncovered earlier from getting that map? Okay, also, how am I doing on health? Oh, I'm still on fine, that's cool. Okay, so because we now have insecticide, let's examine it. It's a pump action spray, there's plenty of insecticide inside. Okay, so we come up to this hole, and if you check the map, the hole... It leads directly into where the wasp's nest, the bee's nest, is on the other side of the room. So what we do is we use the second side hole here. Yep, and now we're done with that. So the bees are dead. We can now safely explore that room. Okay, let's go back in there. So let's see. Yeah, there's no more bees in here, so that's cool. Also, this guy is like pre-rendered into the environment, so I don't think he's gonna become a zombie. I don't think so, at least. I might be mistaken, but also you can see his face a little bit more clearly here. That's, as they say, fuck bees. Definitely fox bees. Okay, I will not, because I only have one space left. What's in here? Yeah, I kind of need this one first. Okay. So what does this one say? Alright, 003. Okay, cool. So the room for this is like right here. Alright, so hold on. Yeah, this one. We use the room for 003. That's not very useful. This kid is carded. Yes. Okay, so now I can go back up. And pick up this little thing here. Red herbs. And now we can go into that room and see what's going on over there. If there's any zombies, I can take care of them. No problem. Okay. So let's see. What's on the other side of the room? There's something here. An ink ribbon. Okay. Come back for that later. Okay, so there's nothing in here. I don't hear something though. Oh. Hi. I have plant roots. A giant plant is crushing the wall. A swarm of angry moths surrounds it. Now, I don't believe the moths are enemies, but, now we know Plant 42 is probably pretty close by. If that's what's going on here. Also, there's a typewriter here. So, this is a safe room. So, I imagine no zombies will come hunting for me, but maybe in the bathroom they will. Let's find out. Hello? Okay, no zombies here. Let's see, the tap of the wash bin doesn't seem to be working. So what is this? Full of dirty water. Pull out the block. Okay, now hold on. Me. Just line out with various soap containers. There's umbrella oil products all over it. Okay. Actually, I'm gonna do something before we do this. Let me go back out. Let me go back out. Okay, there. Oh, few moths. Where the one... Were one of the most annoying things I had to deal with in Majora's Mask. Why does this game keep reminding me of Legend of Zelda games? Maybe it's the insect and plant enemies that are reminding you of it so much. I mean, not so much the other things. Okay, the shelf is lined with red books. There's one white book sandwiched in between them. Take it. Organic chemistry lab experiment. The similarities in the cellular characteristics of the rapidly growing plant infected by the tyrant virus. So that's the T-virus, the tyrant virus. That's the thing that turns people into zombies. Have been reported in previous papers. However, while repeating these experiments, an interesting new fact became clear. We learned that a chemical in the UMB family, UMB number 20, contains a compound that is toxic to the cells of the plant. We have given UMB number 20 a new name, V-Jolt. If calculation proves correct, when V-Jolt is applied directly to the root of the plant, the entire plant should be dead within 5 seconds. The V-Jolt can be made by simply mixing the VP and UMB chemicals in a specific ratio. However, extra care must be taken when handling these UMB chemicals. They have been known to generate toxic gases if mishandled. The characteristics of each UMB chemicals are as follows. UMB number 3 is red, yellow 6 is yellow. Yes, UMB number 7 is green, UMB number 10 is orange, VP number 17 is blue, and then V-Jolt is dark brown. Okay, we need to remember that stuff. Yeah, so that's what the T-virus stands for. Yeah, the tyrant virus. It's for tyrants. Okay, so the space between the books catches your attention. Well, good thing we have this book over here, because look at it on the side. It's a book with a red cover, so that actually completes the thing. But it's out of order. The binding of the book seems to form some kind of pattern. Reorder the books. Okay, so let's put that one like... Okay, so the feet should go like over here. Reorder the books, yes, okay, so... Or actually, no, it should go over here. Or not. Wait, no, okay, and I get it now. Okay, so put this one like at the end. Okay, so now this one over here. Okay, we almost got it. Yeah, so this one should go over here. Ah, there we go. That forms the picture. And that opened up. There's a door over there. We're not gonna be going through there though. We're gonna explore the rest of this. And okay, so now I have space to grab whatever is in this bathroom. Oh, that's a naked woman. Yeah, that's a naked... Now, it's fine arts, though. So, I hope Twitch doesn't come for my ass for that. Alright, but, it's full of dirty water. Okay, I should be fine with that. It's just fine art. Okay. So, what's down here? There's something in the bathtub. Oh, a dagger. Go, take it. Anything else here? Nope, that was it. Alright, cool. Okay. So, let's grab the ink ribbon. And now, This room should be clear. Okay. So, now that we have the recipe for the V-Jolt, we'll have to go back to that science, like, biology lab to make it. But in order to make it, I'm gonna need space. So, we gotta first go back to the safe room and put away all our stuff. Okay. And then we'll go back to the science room, make that thing, and then we'll, yeah, we'll do the things. Okay. Man, it doesn't seem like there's any more zombies around here, so I think we're... I believe the next thing we're gonna be dealing with is a boss fight, so now I do kind of want to take in my, my thing. Actually, you know what we should be using? Instead of using the shotgun, like I usually do, I might take the grenade launcher with me instead. That might be more useful for what we're gonna be dealing with soon enough. Okay, so let's put the ring ribbons here. And let me grab these. And let me grab some of these. Okay. We're gonna combine in that. Wait, shit, never mind. I can't. Fuck. Ah, I forgot. Okay. Oh, never mind. So put this one. That instead. Now we can combine this with that. And then that with that. Now we have a bunch more red herbs combinations. And no first aid sprays though. Okay, so what I want is this one actually. But then I want you. And I want you. I want you guys to be like down here with the other herbs. Like that. And like that. And then we can put you guys up here. Okay, so now I still have that. Alright, so let me go ahead and grab my grenade launcher and my incendiary shells. And we're not gonna be needing this right now, so put it away. And am I going to need anything else? I don't think so. But, you know what, just in case, I'm gonna bring that too. So I can put that on something. Alright. But anyways, we have all the space we needed, so let me go back to the science room, so now we can solve that puzzle. Okay, and also, let me get some more water. Also, I would like to point out that we've been streaming for 1 hour, 43 minutes, and as far as I have seen, there have been no stuttering issues. So... yeah, when I said earlier, what I did was change the encoding on OBS. Like, it previously was, like, encoding with, like, X264. And I changed it to, like, NVIDIA. Something or other. And apparently, I read online, that's supposed to, like, bring down your quality a little bit. But in exchange, it won't use as much CPU. And that's exactly what I needed. So, that works for me. I was already not recording at the highest quality anyway, so yeah. Yeah, I was not saying story. Cool. Alright, so here's an empty bottle. Take that. Here's another empty bottle. Take that. One more. And the last one. Okay, so we have 4 empty bottles. So we need to combine these bottles. Here's a red. Okay, it's gonna be number 3. Sure, let's put some down on one of them. Here's gonna be yellow. And here's some water. Fill the empty bottle with water, sure. Okay. So we know gonna be number 3 is, you know, 3. Yellow is 6, and then water is 1. I believe that's all we need to know. Okay, so let's go back to this math test here. So, okay, so 1 + 3 = 4, and 4 + 6 = 10. 1 + 6 = 17. 10 + 7 = 17, and 17 + 3 = 20. So what we need to do is get to 20. So we need to get 17 somehow. All right. So. Okay. So 1 + 3. So red with water will make then be number 4. And then yellow plus 6. So 4 plus 6 will make 10. So 4 and 6 will make 10. Now we have you and me number 10. So now we need 7, which will be 6 plus 1. So in order to make 6, we need to make... we'll get some more yellow 6. I believe you can actually do this with just 3 bottles. You don't need all 4. But I don't know. I didn't feel like leaving the 4th one out. Combine this with that. So now we have UMB number 7 and UMB number 10. Combine those two together. We have VP 17. And now we just need one more UMB number 3. And that will make 17 plus 3. You got the V-Jolt. It's a distinctly brown liquid. Yep. So, with this, we can go back to the aqua tank where the root of Plant 42 was and put this on it and kill the freaking thing. That's exactly what we're gonna do. Is there a boss fight? Is this a boss fight? Matt! Yeah, Matt is the boss fight. That's the worst kind of boss fight. Oh, God. It's almost as hard as the tutorial in Cuphead. Only that is the hardest. Is harder than this. Okay. Let's go back to, down there. And I don't even think I need to go back to the safe room to, rearrange my stuff. Because I'm just gonna be coming down real quick to put some poison on some plants and take care of that. I don't believe there will be any zombies down here now. I mean, there might be, but I don't think there will be. Okay. Yes, let's climb down the ladder. What's one thing I want to do real quick? Reload this with that instead. Okay. Well, actually, the first thing we're going to use is this one. So when it comes time to use this thing, I'll go ahead and do it. But otherwise, we just gotta come down here, go up to the root room, and do what we need to do with that. Alright, so let's go down. Okay, this stream has been unusually light on zombies, but the sharks made up for it. Yeah, at the beginning of Resident Evil 1, you will fight a lot of zombies, but as the game progresses, we will fight different kinds of enemies. So, yeah, the further down we go, the less zombies we're gonna see. Until, like, the end, where zombies once again become the main enemy. But, yeah. Alright, and that Lisa character I missed at the beginning. She's kind of a zombie. She's like half more sentient than an average zombie, but she's also a lot stronger than an average zombie, so there's also that to keep in mind. Okay. Yeah, anyways, you're still there. I'm not boring with you. Okay. So let's come in here. See what's going on with that. So we just go right under this root. That doesn't hurt us for some reason, and just the V-Jolt. You probably don't need the ball anymore. Throw it away? Yeah. Can I also throw away all the other bottles? Oh, cool! They actually throw away all the bottles. So cool, I don't need to go back to the save room anymore. But maybe I should save still. Because I don't think we're about... We might have to fight a boss fight soon, though. So, Oh boy, just like the ending of Angel of Darkness. Angel of Darkness. Is that Tomb Raider 6? The Angel of Darkness you're talking about? Or the Dark Angel? Or are you talking about a different game? Because I'd be a little bit surprised if you were talking about Tomb Raider 6 of all things right now. It's probably a different game, but anyways. Okay, let's see what's going on. Yeah, so I am actually gonna go ahead and go back to the safe room and save real quick. No, I'm talking about the tentacle plants. Ah, okay. That's a different thing I'm thinking about. Alright. Cool. So... yeah, okay, so we do believe we have most of what we need. But yeah, I'm still gonna stop by the safe room, just in case. Okay. Alright. Moving over here. Yeah, there's a ladder, climb it up. Alright, so this... I would like to put out this does look like a freaking toy, but it is a powerful gun. But it definitely most definitely looks like a toy. Also, was also not there in the original Resident Evil 1. They had... PS1 Resident Evil 1 had the Magnum, but not the mini Magnum. Alright, I just now noticed you're carrying a grenade launcher. This must be something big coming up. Yeah, I guess... the effect kind of... the blind effect kind of wears off when I'm not actually playing blind. I could be playing this game pretending like I don't know shit. Like, I don't know what's happening and I could go into all sorts of rooms unprepared and pretend that I don't know what's gonna happen, but... I kind of figured that it might just be a better watching experience if I just go through the game a bit more smoothly using my knowledge rather than pretending like I have no idea what I'm doing. Anyways, I'm gonna bring this one as well, just in case. And a safe. Okay. An old typewriter, you can save your progress to your sting ribbon. Okay. I'm gonna save over here. Yeah, we're almost at the end of the stream. I think I could just use this as my last save, but no. Alright. Oh no, I'm glad you're constantly prepared. Otherwise, we'd probably be in here a lot of game overs and longer than usual boss battles. Yeah. Even then, don't... I still would expect to... I mean, okay. Well, I don't think I've... I got a game over in this game when I first played it. Then again, I was playing on easy, so I'm not sure about that. But at least if I come prepared for boss fight, I should be a bit more aware of what's happening. Resident Evil will usually gives me a lot of close calls, but it's actually very rare for me to get a game over in one of these games. Okay, Resident Evil 4. Resident Evil 4 gave me a lot of game overs, but and maybe Resident Evil 5, but those are like super action-packed games that are like, you know, very action-y. The horror games that require more preparation rather than raw skill. Yeah, those I'm a little bit better with. Okay. Anyways. So let's go ahead and go through here and see what's going on the other side of this room.
What the hell is this thing?
Barry!
Jill!
Finished.
Yeah.
That was close. Thanks again.
Don't mention it. But what was that? What the hell's going on in this place?
I completely forgot. We're playing Jill's campaign, not Chris's campaign. In Chris's campaign, you have to fight it. In Jill's campaign, Barry comes to save the day.
Barry.
Something about that mansion still bothers me. But I think I'll stay here a little longer. We should split up again and investigate.
All right.
Well, anyways, I like super prepared myself and even wasted a save for nothing. I feel dumb now. I forgot that Barry is just the man. He comes to save you every time. But I think we would have actually had to fight that boss fight if we hadn't gone downstairs to use the Vigilt on the root. And also, in Chris's campaign, you can still do that. But you still have to fight a boss fight. It'll just be weaker than if you hadn't used the Vigilt. So, you know, puzzle solving in Chris's campaign will make the boss fight easier. In Jill's campaign, it'll completely annihilate the boss fight. So, keep that in mind when you're playing this game yourself. If you play this game yourself. Okay. Is there any other items out here? Like, I mean, I know there was like a shiny thing down there, but like, is there anything else? Any ammo? Supplies? Nothing. Okay, we'll just... There's a... Okay. Cool, we'll just, grab whatever this thing is. That's a key. Will you take the mansion key? Also, hold on, right, before I take it. Again, look at the size of that freaking thing. Okay. Size compared... Look at the dagger on Jill's, like, hip. And then compare it to the size of the key down there. It's the same size. That key is the size of a forearm. Jesus Christ, why are the keys in this house mansion so big? Pretty sure the keyholes aren't as big as the keys themselves. Okay, the keymaster. Oh, I got a trophy for that. Okay, cool. It's nothing unusual, but checking the other side, it's a helmet key. As you guys remember, there were a bunch of helmet key doors down there in the old mansion. So, well, Barry's just gonna be here now, so go over him. And he's no longer locked, so that's nice. You don't have to tell me twice to stare at Jill's hips. Oh boy, yeah. There are actually some outfits, again, I mentioned earlier, but there are outfits you can unlock, and you can bet some of them are a bit more showing than the standard outfit.
Wesker.
Jill, so you're safe.
That's what I was going to say.
I apologize. It was all I could do to protect myself against those strange creatures.
I understand. Anyway, it's good that you're safe.
Did you notice? Barry, you sounded a little flaky.
Now that you mention it, yeah. I'll keep a close eye.
Maybe it's quite natural under these circumstances. It's not really our standard operation. Jill, our first priority is to get out of here.
I agree.
There are still rooms in that mansion we can't get into because they're locked up. I've been looking for ways to...
Okay, if there's anything, I'll go back to the other mansion.
I'm counting on you.
Okay, cool, Wesker. And where are you going to go? Hey, Wesker? I've already explored everything that there is to explore in here. I think so. Yes, I have. Wesker, you... There's literally nothing else for you to do here. Also, I think I missed a door down there. But, whatever. I almost completely forgot Whisker was even in this game. Yeah, no, he's in this game. He doesn't appear too much, but, you know, he's here. Shows up eventually, occasionally. I mean, okay, I'm not sure if it's even worth it to hide Wesker's personality since he's such an iconic character in, you know, normal history and a lot of people know about him, about his antics, but, I guess I'll try to keep Wesker's identity as secret as possible for anyone who hasn't played Resident Evil and is not aware of the lore of the later games, I guess. Okay. But regardless, we're pretty much done here now, so... Yeah, I guess so. Now what we have to do is go back to the mansion and bring the helmet key. But, we did pretty much everything that I wanted to do, so let me put this back. And let me change the grenade launcher for the shotgun and the shotgun shells. And about it. I guess, do I need anything else? Not really. I don't need the square crank yet either. Yeah, I think we're done. So that's pretty much all I have to do for today. So we'll go ahead and save here, and that will be it for us today. Okay, and I'm also gonna keep pointing this little mini gun. Okay, so if you think about it, I was right before when I said that Matt was the real area boss. Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, the Matt puzzle was the real threat, not the boss itself. Okay. Well, anyways, let's go ahead and save up. I saved 10 minutes ago, and I'm having to save again. That's gonna bring down our score even more. But what can you do? Sometimes I just need to save. All right, but yeah, that's all the time I have for you guys today. So next week we'll go back to the other mansion, use the helmet key over here, but unlock all the other doors that we haven't unlocked. And yeah, we'll probably find more items to help us progress through even more areas of the mansion, or maybe even a new area. But yeah, that'll be for next week's Friday. Join me tomorrow as we delve back into the horrors of Fatal Frame. Now that's the real spooky game that we're playing this month. And yeah, okay, so that's it. So well, ladies and gentlemen, this has been all for today, and so here says goodbye, Hollow Play 45.